When filtering and interacting with a direct query report, end users want the best of both worlds: snappy performance and access to more of the raw data. For those looking for more query performance optimizations without compromising on report interactivity, we're introducing a new feature: Dynamic M Query Parameters. This new Microsoft Power BI feature allows M Query parameters to be dynamically updated by report consumers based on their filter or slicer selections. By giving authors control over how end users' filters get incorporated into the source query, they can optimize the performance of the query and also allow end users to freely interact with the report using slicers or filters. The end user experience will feel the same as a standard report, and by simply changing a filter, the query parameter is automatically updated based on their selection, something that was not previously possible for report consumers. In this example, the model author has several parameters created for repo name, start time, and end time. To see how the parameter is referenced in the query, navigate to Main Query and then select Advanced Editor. Here's where performance optimization can be achieved by controlling how the filter gets incorporated in the query. For instance, filtering on the parameter before other more costly operations in the query can help improve performance. Note that this only works when the parameters are referenced directly in the M query. Next, going into the Modeling tab, you can see the fields that will map to the parameters. In this case, the end date, the start date, and repo name, which contain all the possible values for the parameter shown earlier. Let's move forward, looking at the repo name parameter. In the Advanced tab, you'll see the option for Bind to Parameter. Now, whenever repo name is filtered by a user, the filter value will be passed to the parameter. The author also has the multi-select option turned on, which allows for selection of multiple repo names, not just one. The same options are available for the start date and end date parameters as well, yet here we would want the multi-select option turned off in order to isolate only a single start date and end date. In the report view, these fields mapped to the parameters must be used as a slicer or filter. Here, a user has referenced the start date, end date, and repo in slicers. You'll see as these values are changed, the parameters and query will be dynamically updated, essentially updating the query parameters by default without the end user even being aware of it, which can be a significant performance improvement, especially for larger data sets.